This week's Ask Dr. Durie comes from a gentleman who wants to know, what is the difference between genetic testing such as FISH testing and DNA testing? And so this is obviously a very important question. Those are very different test techniques, but both of them are evaluating the chromosomes within the myeloma cells. And so what it means that is that for both of these tests, one does need a sample of the myeloma cells, usually from the bone marrow. Occasionally one could get it from the blood or from a tissue sample, but typically from the bone marrow. In the case of the FISH testing, what is done is that the chromosomes of the cells are stained with a fluorescent dye, and this makes the chromosomes light up in different colors, so that when a pathologist looks at the chromosomes under a microscope, he can distinguish which chromosomes are present and if there are any mutations or changes within the chromosomes. Using this technique, the FISH testing can be used to perform what is called risk stratification. And so one can look for changes in the FISH test results such that there is a loss of the top of chromosome number 17, which is called 17p minus. One can look for a switch between chromosomes 4 and 14, which is called translocation 414. Similarly, for translocation 1416. One can also look to see if there is extra DNA on the bottom part of chromosome number 1, which is called 1q+. And so this is a routine testing technique which is used to risk stratify myeloma based on the bone marrow myeloma cell results. Conversely, DNA testing is much more precise in that it doesn't require observation by a pathologist. This is a lab-based method where mutations are assessed using molecular testing techniques. And in this case, a whole range of different mutations can be identified and classified. And in the case of myeloma, there are indeed many mutations to assess. In addition, one can look using a test called GEP, gene expression profiling, to see which of these mutations are currently active in the growing myeloma cells. And this is very, very helpful. This is an aspect of what is called precision medicine, where one looks at the mutations, which ones are present, which ones are active, in an effort to identify new therapies which can shut down abnormally active genes. And so looking at the DNA is a very different methodology. And so in this case, the bottom line is FISH testing is a standard technique which we still widely use. DNA testing is a new technology which will undoubtedly lead in these next few years to precision medicine approaches where therapy can be directed against the specific pattern of mutations present in a particular set of myeloma cells. So very different techniques, both very important, and this is the current status in day-to-day use.